Welcome, and thanks for joining us here in Jerusalem for this roundup of the 2021 Eli Hurvitz Conference on Economy and Society. Israel's top decision makers gathered here at a momentous time for the country, both politically and economically, with a brand new government in place.
After 2.5 years without one, Israel's new government must move quickly to pass a budget reflecting the new post-pandemic priorities. More broadly, they have to demonstrate that Israel's democracy can still deliver after years of instability, stagnation, and paralysis.
These are daunting challenges for newly appointed Finance Minister Avigdor Liberman, who praised the new spirit of cooperation among the members of Israel's new government. But he told the conference that despite pressing demands, he intends to keep the budget deficit in check.
Toda le Yohanan Plesner ובאמת למכון לדמוקרטיה שאני דווקא נעזר הרבה גם כשהייתי באופוזיציה וגם כשבקואליציה. מבחינתי אנחנו ננהל מדיניות מאוד אחראית, ממלכתית, בלי גזירות, בלי מיסים, אבל קודם כל מדיניות אחראית ולא נשתולל עם כל הלחצים הפוליטיים שישנם. אנחנו חייבים כמו כולם, וראינו בארצות הברית דוגמה נהדרת, שם להשקיע בתשתיות ובתחום התשתיות, וכמובן הפריון, אנחנו נמצאים מתחת לכל ביקורת.
Bank of Israel Governor, Professor Amir Yaron, backed the finance minister's insistence on fiscal restraint, but he implied that raising taxes may not be the worst solution, as Israel's current tax rate is the lowest among OECD countries.
In terms of the government, and this is a very important conference, it brings in many of the important stakeholders that are relevant for the what the government will do next. And obviously the budget, we haven't had a budget for 2 years. The budget incorporates the preferences of the government, as well as all the reforms and the investments that we need to do in order to ensure that we have growth and improvements in the economy in the next 5 to 10 years.
Joining us from abroad, Paul Singer, co-CEO of Elliott Investment Management, told conference participants that inflation in the United States is on the rise and the current stock market bubble may burst.
I think there are two large challenges that sort of hover above all the rest. One is that the policy response to COVID, built on top of the policy response to the global financial crisis of 2008-9, has created a unique situation in financial markets. There's a stock market boom or bubble, however you want to describe it, that on many metrics, close to all metrics, is the most expensive, most highly valued stock market in history.
Singer's remarks were part of a wide-ranging discussion of priorities for Israel in the post-COVID world. Professor Karine Flug, Vice President and William Davidson Senior Fellow for Economic Policy at IDI, was optimistic, noting the strong recovery of the world's economies from the pandemic. She stressed that Israel's famed high-tech industry continues to prosper and was in fact unaffected by COVID. However, Professor Flug does have concerns about the Israeli labor market.
The pandemic actually caused a very strong blow to people with low skill, where people, high-skilled people, actually enjoyed continued demand and increase in wages. So it actually expanded very much social gaps, and that may remain with us.
One of the things that I'm very, very disappointed to see is that the Israeli government missed the opportunity of COVID, of mass furlough and unemployment, to actually retrain people while they were not working anyway.
In a remarkable, indeed historic moment at the conference, four newly appointed senior cabinet ministers of economy, transport, environment, and energy, all of them women, appeared together to announce a joint effort to drastically reduce carbon emissions over the coming decades and transition to renewable energy. This was an endorsement of the recommendations of an inter-agency task force led by IDI to prepare Israel's economy for 2050.
Here today, we will stand four ministers, including the energy minister, that there is our greatest challenge. And our goal is to have agreed and ambitious goals for Israel towards Glasgow.
Transport Minister Merav Michaeli emphasized how unique it is to have four government ministers come together in this way to promote a joint vision.
יש בינינו דיבור על שיתופי פעולה. אני חושבת שכשאתן מחפשות סיבה למה צריך יותר ויותר נשים בעמדות כוח, הנה לכם דוגמה.
The ministers emphasized that government investment in tackling climate crisis by reducing carbon emissions is also a socio-economic opportunity to create incentives for green growth and leverage Israeli innovation and creativity. Major business leaders weighed in on the discussion, showing how the business sector must lead the way.
It is inevitable that governments, through their regulators, are going to have to step in and mandate the publication of accounts that show not just profit, but also the different impacts that companies create from their operations, from their employment, and from their products on people and planet.
המדינה חייבת לפעול להקמת תשתית מתאימה, אבל בינתיים למגזר העסקי אסור לחכות לממשלה. המגזר העסקי חייב להוביל ולהיות החלוץ במחנה ולהוביל ליצירת הסטנדרט שבהמשך המדינה תאמץ אותו בחקיקה, פיקוח, תכנון וביצוע. זה נכון לעתיד שלנו, זה נכון לישראל, זה נכון לסביבה וזה נכון לעסקים. תודה רבה.
And on that note of cautious optimism that prevailed in much of the discussion here, we come to the end of this roundup of this year's Eli Hurvitz Conference on Economy and Society, organized by the Israel Democracy Institute. I'm Leah Zinder in Jerusalem.